This is the global ocean conveyor belt. It's a system of ocean currents that transport warm and cold waters around the world to regulate regional climates. And this part of the conveyor belt in the North Atlantic region is considered the engine, the most powerful part that gives the system the momentum it needs to work properly. In the tropics near Florida, a band of warm, salty surface water called the Gulf Stream is carried by winds towards Greenland, where it is cold enough for sea ice to form. But because salt can't freeze, the ice leaves it behind as it forms, which makes the surrounding seawater saltier and, therefore, denser. This causes the cold, salty, dense water to sink and begin moving south as it is replaced by new warm waters, eventually flowing along the bottom of the ocean towards Antarctica and around the planet. This circulation pattern, powered by temperature and salinity differences, can be disrupted with global warming, which is what is happening today. As the oceans become warmer, less ice is able to form, and more fresh water enters the oceans from melted glaciers, sea ice, and ice sheets. A lack of ice or an influx of fresh water means the seawater is less salty, and therefore not dense enough to sink the way it normally would, ultimately making the ocean circulation system weaker. So as the planet gets warmer and more ice melts, the climate system may reach a tipping point where the conveyor belt slows down enough to cause regional climate changes around the world, but especially in the North Atlantic region, because this is where the most amount of water and heat is transported, moving from the eastern United States towards Europe. Warm waters would pile on the U.S. East Coast side, causing higher sea levels and stronger hurricanes. And on the other side of the Atlantic, less warm water from the Gulf Stream would reach Western Europe, resulting in severe winter weather. A slower ocean circulation system could also reduce rainfall over the Amazon. It could change monsoon systems in Asia and West Africa, resulting in drought over the Sahel. Or it could transport warm waters into the Southern Ocean, which would further destabilize the Antarctica sheet and speed up sea level rise. While scientists are closely monitoring changes in ocean circulation patterns, they're also monitoring natural carbon sinks, like the permafrost region, because as it thaws, it can abruptly release massive amounts of greenhouse gases, which in turn would make the planet warmer and trigger the ocean conveyor belt to slow or potentially stop. In the next video, we'll talk about the permafrost region and how it impacts the climate system.